Hi, in this video I'll be answering one more question. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button super thanks. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. This is something about a non-starting engine. This question comes from a viewer. And he says, at first the car wouldn't just idle well. Now the car is not even starting anymore. The fuel doesn't flow to the injectors. The fuel pump is working, but the fuel from distributor doesn't come out to the injectors. The car doesn't even start with a spray starter. Well, the answer to this question can be easy, let's say it like that. Concerning the fact that all of you who write me have done something on your car, and that was something about the ignition. Either you have been replacing the spark plugs, their cables, the distributor, the rotor, the distributor cap, and maybe even the ignition coil. And that's everything you have done on your system. But concerning the system itself, you've done nothing or few things. So this leads me to the fact that if you have to do anything on your car in this situation, you would have to now measure your pressures. You must have a pressure gauge and measure your pressures. If you do not know how to do that, here is the link. So, now, it can be many, many things. For example, after you have measured the pressure, and if you get everything below the nominal value, as we are talking in this video about M102 engine, it's 5.5 bar system pressure. If you get 3, for example, or 3.5, that's too little. That's not good enough even to open the injectors, to for them to start atomizing. And in this situation, you would have to replace either the fuel pump or pumps and the fuel pressure regulator. Now, if you get the nominal value concerning the system pressure, and if you get the same value when you measure the control pressure, then as the pressures equalize, then you will have no flow towards the injectors from the distributor. In that situation, I'm going to show you what you're supposed to do. In that situation, you're supposed to remove your EHA valve and you will have to remove the protection screw. Okay, I have pre-loosened the screws, so as for you, it's going to be harder, and be careful not to damage it. Here, done. So you have the screw and its washer. Be careful not to lose this washer. The next thing you do, you take this Allen. This is, as you can see, 2 mils Allen. You can take the conventional Allen key, you can take this T handle, no matter. And now what you actually do, you put the Allen key in here like this, and you turn the key for half a turn clockwise. There you get everything back on its place. Here, like this, and you mount the EHA back on its place on the fuel distributor. And then again, you repeat the process, you read out your pressures. If nothing changes, then try again for half a turn clockwise. So be careful clockwise. If again nothing changes, if again you don't get the increase in the differential pressure, then it's most likely that your EHA valve needs replacement. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, happy Mercedesing. Bye.